Hi, I'm Matt Muldoon. I'm a director at a company called Clear Business Outcome, a company dedicated to the sales, implementation, and support of ERP systems or improvement of the systems that businesses have. This is the third in a series of video blogs about taking a common sense approach to ERP system implementations or improvement of the systems that you already have. In the first two, I talked about defining the journey that you wanted to take. Where do you want to go, and how are you going to decide when you reach there? What is your measure for success? In this one, I actually want to take a step back and talk about how do you decide whether or not you need to replace or improve your ERP system. As a business, Clear Business Outcome often comes across companies that are prepared to change their ERP systems. But when we go deep into that business, we find that by using what they already have and improving the processes that they have, they do not need to make the investment to replace. They can improve what they do by improving their processes and using what is already available in their software. One of the things I find when I work with companies is that there tends to be a lot of what we call shelfware, items that you've purchased that you're not using now. And they're features that you did buy at the time because you wanted to use them, but you never reached the stage of implementing them. Before you go about buying something new, consider what you have. Now, of course, there are reasons why you might not be able to use that, because changes in technology may force a change. But you can also always, of course, consider upgrading. But before you go down the route, even if you are going to replace, what you really want to do is make sure that you understand what your processes are. And by doing that, check the health of your business and its use of its systems. If you do that, whether or not you replace, you're going to be ultimately much more successful. And by understanding what your processes are, you can much more easily define how you're going to make them better. In the fourth blog, we're going to talk about how your process improvements can make you decide whether or not you're ready to change. I hope this has been useful. Thank you.